أهلا بك في مملكة البحرين الحبيبة. على أرض استاد البحرين الوطني. بهذه المناسبة نتقدم بالشكر الجزيل إلى جلالة الملك حمد بن عيسى آل خليفة المعظم وإلى القيادة الرشيدة لدعوته لقداسة البابا للتواجد على هذه الأرض على أرض مملكة البحرين.
We welcome the Holy Father to the National Stadium of Bahrain, to the Kingdom of Bahrain, the land of peace. We take this moment to also thank the leadership of this country for this country of where we live in harmony, free to practice our faith. We thank the leadership, His Majesty the King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa, His Royal Highness the Crown Prince Sheikh Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa, for their kind invitation, and the people of Bahrain for their kind invitation of His Holiness Pope Francis. Viva el Papa!
Viva la Papa!
Papa Francesco. Papa Francesco.
And my dear brothers and sisters, here arrives our most beloved Holy Father, Pope Francis. Let us give him a rousing applause. Say, Viva Papa! Sisters, the history is being uncovered before our eyes. Incredible, dear brothers and sisters, incredible. God bless the Kingdom of Bahrain. God bless the King. God bless the royal family. God bless every one of us. Praise God, praise God. God bless us all. God bless us all.
Ahlan wa sahlan, ahlan wa sahlan.
Yeah.
أنت حياتنا نمشي معك في الدروب نحيا معك للأبد
أنت
أيها الأخوة والأخوات، دعونا نرحب بسعادة السيد نواف بن محمد المعوضة وزير العدل وشؤون الإسلامية والأوقاف. إن حضوركم اليوم يجسد التعايش الذي نعيشها في مملكة البحرين، كما يجسد علاقة المودة والرحمة ما بين شعب مملكة البحرين والكنيسة. نود أن نشكر مملكة البحرين على استضافتها اللطيفة وكرمها في ترتيبات المتاخذة لحدث اليوم، وعلى دعمها المستمر لحريتنا في ممارسة عقيدتنا. نشكركم ونرحب بكم في هذه اللحظة التاريخية.
Brothers and sisters, we'd like you to join us to greet His Excellency Nawaf bin Muhammad Al-Muwadda, the Minister of Justice, Islamic Affairs and Endowments. We thank the Kingdom of Bahrain for its generosity and kindness in the arrangement made for today's event, and for its continuous support for our freedom to practice our faith. Your presence today is another great sign of a truly fraternal relationship that this country, its leaders, and its people has always had with our church and its faithful. We thank you and welcome you to this historic moment.
أصحاب السعادة الحاضرين، أيها الإخوة والأخوات في الإيمان، سيبدأ الآن الاحتفال الإفخارستي، وفي غمرة بهجتنا بتواجد قداسة البابا معنا، نود أن نذكركم بأننا مجتمعين هنا للصلاة والتأمل معاً بإيمان وخشوع واحترام. لذلك نرجو منكم خلال القداس عدم التلويح بالأعلام أو الشعارات، وعدم التحدث بصوت مرتفع أو الصراخ، كما نرجو منكم تجنب تناول الطعام.
Your Excellencies, brothers and sisters, the entrance procession of the Eucharistic celebration is about to commence. As we share in the joy of the Holy Father celebrating the Holy Mass, please be reminded that this is a moment of prayer and reflection. Please do not wave flags or banners. Do not scream or shout. Please avoid eating during the Mass.
كما يرجى مراعاة أن القربان المقدس يتناوله فقط المعمدون الذي نالوا سر القربان الأقدس. لذا يرجى من الآخرين البقاء جالسين والمشاركة في الترنيم. سيأتي مقدم القربان المقدس مع مرشدين إلى مكان قريبا منكم للمناولة. يرجى الجلوس واتباع التعليمات من المتطوعين. والآن لنشارك في هذه الصلاة بإيمان وخشوع.
At the moment of Holy Communion, please note, Holy Communion is only for baptized Christians who have received the sacrament of Holy Eucharist. Others, please remain seated and join in the singing. Eucharistic ministers with their ushers will come to a marked place close to you. Kindly be seated and follow the instruction of volunteers. Let us enter into this sacrament in a spirit of faith and devotion.
We invite the choir to lead us in song as the entrance procession begins. Please rise. Brothers and sisters, please rise.
Thank you. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sin and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, my words, and what I have done, and in what I have failed to do, through my fault. Therefore, the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Glory to
Let us pray. O God, who show our fathers care for all, grant in your mercy that the members of the human race, to whom you have given a single origin, may form in peace a single family, and always be united by a fraternal spirit. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, forever, forever.
قراءة من سفر أشعيا النبي. الشعب السالك في الظلمة أبصر نورا عظيما، الجالسون في بقعة الموت وظلاله أشرق عليهم نور. كثرت الأمة، وفرت لها الفرح، يفرحون أمامك كالفرح في الحصاد، كابتهاج الذين يتقاسمون السلب. لأن نير مشقتها وعصا كتفها وقضيب مسخرها قد كسرتها، كما في يوم مدين. إن كل حذاء يحدث جلبة، وكل ثوب متلطخ بالدماء يصيران للحرق ووقودا للنار. لأنه قد ولد لنا ولد، وأعطي لنا ابن، فصارت الرئاسة على كتفه، ودعي اسمه عجيبا، مشيرا إلها جبارا، أبد الأبد، رئيس السلام. لنمو الرئاسة ولسلام لا انقضاء له على عرش داود ومملكته، ليقرها ويوطدها بالإنصاف والعدل من الآن إلى الأبد. إن غيرة رب الجنود تصنع هذا. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Kindness and truth shall meet. Kindness and truth shall meet.
Kindness and truth shall meet. Glory dwelling in
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O
Jesus said to his disciples, "You have heard that it was said, an eye for an eye, and a tooth for a tooth. But I say to you, offer no resistance to one who is evil. When someone strikes you on your right cheek, turn the other one as well. If anyone wants to go to law with you over your tunic, hand over your cloak as well. Should anyone press you into service for 1 mile, go for 2 miles. Give to the one who asks of you, and do not turn your back on one who wants to borrow. You have heard that it was said, you shall love your neighbor and hate your enemy. But I say to you, love your enemies and pray for those who persecute you, that you may be children of your heavenly Father. For he makes his sun rise on the bad and the good, and causes the rain to fall on the just and the unjust. For if you love those who love you, what recompense will you have? Do not the tax collectors do the same? And if you greet your brothers only, what is unusual about that? Do not the pagans do the same? So be perfect, just as your heavenly Father is perfect. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
El profeta Isaías dice que Dios hará surgir un Mesías cuya soberanía será grande y habrá una paz sin fin. Parece una contradicción, ya que de hecho en la apariencia de este mundo lo que muchas veces vemos es que cuanto más se busca el poder, más amenazada está la paz. En cambio, el profeta da un anuncio extraordinariamente novedoso. El Mesías que llega es poderoso, sí, pero no a la manera de un caudillo que trae la guerra y domina a los otros, sino en cuanto príncipe de la paz, como aquel que reconcilia a los hombres con Dios y entre ellos. La grandeza de su poder no usa la fuerza de la violencia, sino la debilidad del amor. Y este es el poder de Cristo, el amor. Y también a nosotros, Él nos confiere el mismo poder, poder de amar en su nombre, de amar como Él ha amado, como de manera incondicional, no solo cuando todo va bien y sentimos el deseo de amar, sino siempre, no solo a nuestros amigos y vecinos, sino a todos, incluso a los enemigos, siempre y a todos.
The prophet Isaiah says about the Messiah whom God will raise up.
His power shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace. This sounds like a contradiction in terms. On the world scene, we often notice that the more power is sought, the more peace is threatened. Instead, the prophet announces extraordinary news. The Messiah to come will indeed be powerful, not in the manner of a commander who wages war and rules over others, but as the Prince of Peace, who reconciles people with God and with one another. His great power does not come from the force of violence, but from the weakness of love. This is Christ's power. It is love. Jesus gives us that same power, the power to love in his name, to love as he loved. How? Unconditionally. Not only when things are going well and we feel like loving, but always. Not only towards our friends and neighbors, but towards everyone, including our enemies. Love always and love everyone.
Amar siempre y amar a todos. Reflexionemos un poco sobre esto. En primer lugar, hoy las palabras de Jesús nos invitan a amar siempre, es decir, a permanecer siempre en su amor, a cultivarlo y practicarlo, cualquiera que sea la situación que vivimos. Pero atención, la mirada de Jesús es concreta, no dice que será fácil, y no propone un amor sentimental o romántico, como si en nuestras relaciones humanas no existiesen momentos de conflictos y entre los pueblos no hubiera motivos de hostilidad. Jesús no es irenista, sino realista. Habla explícitamente de los que les hacen el mal y de enemigos. Sabe que en nuestras relaciones tiene lugar una lucha cotidiana entre el amor y el odio, y que también dentro de nosotros cada día se verifica un combate entre la luz y las tinieblas, entre muchos propósitos y deseos de bien y esa fragilidad pecaminosa que frecuentemente nos domina y nos arrastra hacia las obras del mal. Sabe también qué es lo que experimentamos cuando, a pesar de tantos esfuerzos generosos, no recibimos el bien que nos esperábamos, sino que incomprensiblemente sufrimos un daño. E incluso ve y sufre observando en nuestros días, en tantas partes del mundo, formas de ejercer el poder que se nutren del abuso y la violencia, que buscan aumentar su propio espacio, restringiendo el de los demás, imponiendo su dominio, limitando las libertades fundamentales y oprimiendo a los débiles. Por tanto, dice Jesús, existen conflictos, opresiones y enemistades.
To love always and to love everyone. Let us stop and reflect on this. First, Jesus' words today invite us to love always. That is, to always remain in his love, to cultivate that love and to put it into practice, whatever the situation in which we live. Notice, though, that Jesus' vision is completely practical. He does not say it will be easy, and he is not talking about sentimental or romantic love, as if in our human relationships there will not be any moments of conflict or grounds for hostility among peoples. Jesus is not idealistic, but realistic. He speaks explicitly of evil and enemies. He knows that within our relationships there is a daily struggle between love and hatred. Within our hearts, too, there is a daily clash between light and darkness, between our many resolutions and desires, and the sinful weakness that often takes over and drags us into doing evil. He also knows that for all our generous efforts, we do not always receive the good we expect, and indeed, sometimes, incomprehensibly, we suffer evil. What is more, he suffers when he sees in our own day, and in many parts of the world, ways of exercising power that feed on oppression and violence, seeking to expand their own space by restricting that of others, imposing their own domination and restricting basic freedoms, and in this way, oppressing the weak. And so Jesus says, conflict, oppression, and enmity exist among us.
Frente a todo esto, la pregunta importante que debemos hacernos es, ¿qué hacer cuando nos encontramos en estas situaciones? La propuesta de Jesús es sorprendente, es atrevida, es audaz. Él pide a los suyos la valentía de arriesgarse por algo que aparentemente parece la opción perdedora. Pide que permanezcamos siempre fielmente en el amor, a pesar de todo, incluso ante el mal y el enemigo. Reaccionar de una forma simplemente humana nos encadena al ojo por ojo, diente por diente. Pero eso significa hacer justicia con las mismas armas del mal que recibimos. Jesús se atreve a proponernos algo nuevo, algo distinto, impensable, algo suyo. Y dice así, yo les digo que no hagan frente al que les hace mal. Al contrario, si alguien te da una bofetada en la mejilla derecha, preséntale también la otra. Esto nos pide el Señor, no que soñemos con un mundo irónicamente animado por la fraternidad, sino que nos comprometamos en primera persona, empezando por vivir concreta y valientemente la fraternidad universal, perseverando en el bien, incluso cuando recibimos el mal, rompiendo la espiral de la venganza, desarmando la violencia, desmilitarizando el corazón. El apóstol Pablo se hace eco de esto cuando escribe, no te dejes vencer por el mal. Al contrario, vence al mal haciendo el bien.
In light of all this, the important question to ask is, what are we doing? What are we to do in such situations? Jesus' answer is surprising, bold, and daring. He tells his disciples to find the courage to risk something that seems sure to fail. He asks them to remain always faithfully in love, despite everything, even in the face of evil and our enemy. A purely human reaction would restrict us to seeking an eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth, but that would be to exact justice by using the same weapons of evil used on us. Jesus dares to propose something new, different, unthinkable, his own way. I say to you, do not resist one who is evil. But if anyone strikes you on the right cheek, turn to him the other also. This is what the Lord asks of us, not to dream idealistically of a world of fraternity, but to choose, starting with ourselves, to practice universal fraternity concretely and courageously, persevering in good, even when evil is done to us, breaking the spiral of vengeance, disarming violence, demilitarizing the heart. The Apostle Paul echoes Jesus when he writes, "Do not be overcome by evil, but overcome evil with good."
Por tanto, la invitación de Jesús no se refiere en primer lugar a las grandes cuestiones de la humanidad, sino a las situaciones concretas de nuestra vida, a nuestros lazos familiares, a las relaciones en la comunidad cristiana, a los vínculos que se cultivan en la realidad laboral y social en la que nos encontramos. Habrá fricciones, momentos de tensión, habrá conflictos, visiones distintas, pero quien sigue al principio de la paz debe buscar siempre la paz. Y no se puede restablecer la paz si a una palabra ofensiva se le responde con otra. O peor, se le responde con otra peor. Si a una bofetada se le sigue otra. No es necesario desactivar, quebrar la cadena del mal. Es necesario hacer esto, romper la espiral de la violencia, dejar de albergar rencores, dejar de quejarse y compadecerse de sí mismo. Hay que permanecer en el amor siempre, y este es el camino de Jesús para dar gloria a Dios del cielo y construir la paz en la tierra. Amar siempre.
What Jesus asks us to do does not primarily concern the great problems of humanity, but the concrete situations of our daily lives, our relationships in the family and in the Christian community, in the workplace and in society. There will be cases of friction, moments of tension, conflicts and opposing viewpoints, but those who follow the Prince of Peace must always strive for peace. And peace cannot be restored if a harsh word is answered with an even harsher one, or if one slap leads to another. No, we need to disarm, to shatter the chains of evil. This is necessary to do, to break the spiral of violence and to put an end to resentment, complaints, and self-pity. We need to keep loving always. This is Jesus' way of giving glory to the God of heaven and building peace on earth. Love always.
Tomemos ahora el segundo aspecto, amar a todos. Podemos comprometernos en el amor, pero no es suficiente si lo reducimos al estrecho ámbito de aquellos que de quienes recibimos este mismo amor, es decir, de nuestros amigos, de nuestros semejantes, familiares. También en este caso, la invitación de Jesús es sorprendente, porque extiende las fronteras de la ley y del sentido común. Amar al prójimo, amar al que tenemos cerca de nosotros, aunque es razonable, ya es difícil. En general, es lo que una comunidad o un pueblo intentan hacer para conservar la paz internamente. Si uno pertenece a la misma
we can be committed to loving, but it is not enough if we restrict this commitment to the close circle of those who love us, who are our friends, or who are like us. Again, what Jesus asks us to do is amazing because it transcends the boundaries of law and common sense. Loving our neighbor, loving those close to us, though reasonable, is exhausting enough. In general, this is what a community or a people tries to do to preserve its internal peace. If people belong to the same family or nation, or have the same ideas or tastes and profess the same beliefs, it is normal for them to try to help one another and to love one another.
Pero ¿qué sucede si el que está lejos se nos acerca? Si el extranjero, el que es diferente o de otro credo, se convierte en nuestro vecino de casa? Esta tierra es precisamente una imagen viva de la convivencia en la diversidad, de nuestro mundo cada vez más marcado por la permanente migración de los pueblos y del pluralismo de las ideas, de los usos y las tradiciones. Es importante entonces acoger esta provocación de Jesús. Si ustedes aman solamente a quienes los aman, ¿qué recompensa merecen? ¿No hacen lo mismo los publicanos? El verdadero desafío para ser hijos del Padre y construir un mundo de hermanos es aprender a amar a todos, incluso a los enemigos. Ustedes han oído que se dijo, amarás a tu prójimo y odiarás a tu enemigo. Pero yo les digo, amen a sus enemigos, rueguen por sus perseguidores. Esto en realidad significa elegir no tener enemigos, no ver en el otro un obstáculo que se debe superar, sino un hermano y una hermana a quien amar. Amar al enemigo es llevar a la tierra el reflejo del cielo, es hacer bajar sobre el mundo la mirada del corazón del Padre, que no hace distinciones, no discrimina, sino que hace salir el sol sobre malos y buenos, y hace caer la lluvia sobre justos e injustos.
Yet what happens if those who are far distant approach us? If foreigners who are different or hold other beliefs become our neighbors? This very land is a living image of coexistence and diversity, and indeed an image of our world, increasingly marked by the constant migration of peoples and by a pluralism of ideas, customs, and traditions. It is important then to embrace Jesus' challenge. If you love those who love you, what reward have you? Do not even the tax collectors do the same? If we want to be children of the Father and build a world of brothers and sisters, the real challenge is to learn how to love everyone, even our enemies. You have heard that it was said, you shall love your neighbor and hate your enemy. But I say to you, love your enemies and pray for those who persecute you. Concretely, this means choosing not to have enemies, choosing to see in others not an obstacle to be overcome, but a brother or sister to be loved. To love our enemies is to make this earth a reflection of heaven. It is to draw down upon our world the eyes and heart of the Father, who does not distinguish or discriminate, but makes his Son rise on the evil and on the good, and sends rain on the just and on the unjust.
Hermanos, hermanas, el poder de Jesús es el amor. Y Jesús nos da el poder de amar así, de un modo que a nosotros nos parece sobrehumano. Pero una capacidad semejante no puede ser solo fruto de nuestros esfuerzos. Es ante todo una gracia que se debe pedir con insistencia. Jesús, tú que me amas, enséñame a amar como tú, Jesús, tú que me perdonas, enséñame a perdonar como tú, Jesús. Manda sobre mí tu espíritu, el espíritu del amor. Pidamos esto, porque tantas veces presentamos al Señor muchas peticiones, pero esto es lo esencial para el cristiano, saber amar como Cristo. Amar es el don más grande y lo recibimos cuando damos espacio al Señor en la oración, cuando acogemos su presencia en su palabra que nos transforma y en la revolucionaria humildad de su partido. Pan. Así lentamente caen las murallas que endurecen nuestro corazón y encontramos la alegría de practicar obras de misericordia para con todos. Entonces comprendemos que una vida dichosa pasa a través de las bienaventuranzas y consiste en ser constructores de la paz.
Brothers and sisters, the power of Jesus is love. Jesus gives us the power to love in this way, which for us seems superhuman. This ability, though, cannot be merely the result of our own efforts. It is primarily the fruit of God's grace, a grace that must be implored insistently. Jesus, you who love me, teach me to love like you. Jesus, you who forgive me, teach me to forgive like you. Send your Spirit, the Spirit of love, upon me. Let us ask for this grace. So often we bring our requests before the Lord, but what is essential for us as Christians is to know how to love as Christ loves. His greatest gift is the ability to love, and that is what we receive when we make room for the Lord in prayer, when we welcome his presence in his transforming word, and in the revolutionary humility of his broken bread. Thus, slowly, the walls that harden our hearts tumble, and we find our joy in carrying out works of mercy towards everyone. Then we come to realize that happiness in life comes through the Beatitudes and consists in our becoming peacemakers.
Queridos amigos, quisiera agradecer vuestro sereno y alegre testimonio de fraternidad para ser en esta tierra semilla del amor y de la paz. Es el desafío que el Evangelio entrega cada día a nuestras comunidades cristianas, a cada uno de nosotros. Y a ustedes, a todos los que han venido a esta celebración desde los cuatro países del Vicariato Apostólico de Arabia del Norte, Bahrein, Kuwait, Qatar y Arabia Saudita, así como de otros países del Golfo y también de otros territorios, les traigo hoy el
for this celebration from the four countries of the Apostolic Vicariate of Northern Arabia, Bahrain, Kuwait, Qatar, Saudi Arabia, and other countries of the Gulf, and from elsewhere. I bring today the affection and closeness of the Universal Church, which looks to you and embraces you, which loves you and encourages you. May the Blessed Virgin, Our Lady of Arabia, accompany you on your journey and preserve you constantly in love towards all.
we lift up our prayers to the Father, asking him to grant us and all humanity the gift of peace and justice for which we long.
Let our response be, Francis, amche pap saiba pasot, je aaz amche mode hajir asat, devache purjechi seva kartana, tani tambonastana, sotache dut zaunk, ani shantiche kaljidar gawai zaunk, ami tanche pasot maguya. We pray to the Lord.
മെത്രാൻമാർക്കും പുരോഹിതർക്കും സന്യസ്തർക്കും വേണ്ടി മെത്രാൻമാരും പുരോഹിതരും സന്യസ്തരും ക്രൈസ്തവ വിശ്വാസത്തിന് നിർവ്യാജം സാക്ഷ്യം വഹിക്കുന്നതിനും പരിശുദ്ധാത്മാവിൻ്റെ ശക്തിയാലും സഭ മുഴുവൻ്റെയും പ്രാർത്ഥനയാലും അവർ തങ്ങളുടെ ശുശ്രൂഷയിൽ പിന്തുണയ്ക്കപ്പെടുന്നതിനും വേണ്ടി നമുക്ക് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കാം. വി പ്രേ ടു ദ ലോർഡ്.
Para sa mga pinuno na may integridad at karunungan ay gumawa ng mga pagpili pabor sa tunay na kabutihan ng lahat, tunay na kalayaan, katarungan, at kapayapaan. We pray to the Lord.
For those who suffer because of war, hunger, and poverty, may they not be left to themselves, but through the loving witness of their brothers and sisters, may they feel the closeness of our Heavenly Father. We pray to the Lord.
Kwa ajili ya familia zetu, kwa kuongozwa na roho wa upendo, tugundue tena mwelekezo wa ndani ya imani kwa kusikiliza injili katika sala na ukarimu. Tumuombe Baba. We pray to the Lord.
மரணத்தை வென்ற கிறிஸ்துவின் அன்பில் காலத்தின் முடிவில் விண்ணக விருந்தில் பந்தியமர இன்றும் எப்போதும் தங்களின் உயிர்ப்பை எதிர்பார்த்திருக்கும் இறந்த எல்லோருக்காகவும் ஆண்டவரே உம்மை மன்றாடுகிறோம். We pray to the Lord.
Lord, make us
Accept, O Father, these prayers which we bring to you in faith. Grant that our lives we always bear witness to your grace and infinite mercy. Through Christ our Lord.
Father, let us be your
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
May the saving sacrifice of your Son, the King of Peace, offered under sacramental signs that signify peace and unity, strengthen, we pray, O Lord, concord among all your children through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son Jesus Christ, you were through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, and so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all saints, we declare you glory, as without, with one voice we acclaim. Of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, this gift, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, my brother Paul, the Bishop of this church, and me, your unworthy servant, and all the clergy.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. And all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Let us pray. Bestow on us, we pray, O Lord, the spirit of charity, so that sustained by the body and blood of your only begotten Son, we may be effective in nurturing among all the peace that he has left us. Through Christ our Lord.
Holy Father, on behalf of all the faithful here present and those following this celebration on television, I thank Your Holiness for Your visit to Bahrain. It shows Your pastoral care for a tiny church in a tiny country, but a church full of vitality. You have come to us as the successor of Simon Peter, who received from Jesus Christ the charge to strengthen the faith of his brothers and sisters. We are a small flock composed of migrants coming from around the world. On this joyful occasion, we assure you of our prayers and renew our loyalty. Like your patron Saint Francis of Assisi, you are not afraid to build bridges with the Muslim world and to show your fraternal closeness to all people of goodwill, regardless of their cultural background and religious belief. We Christians in the Middle East, those of ancient Oriental tradition, and those who as migrants temporarily live in this part of the world, try to implement the invitation of Saint Francis to his brothers to live spiritually among the Muslims, not to engage in arguments and simply to acknowledge that we are Christians. I wish to thank His Majesty Sheikh Hamad bin Isa bin Salman Al Khalifa, the King of Bahrain, along with the royal family and the members of the government, they have generously made this visit possible and given us the space for a public mass with such a large crowd of worshippers. I thank all the people from the churches in Manama and Avali and other countries of the Arabian Peninsula who have worked hard to make this celebration possible. Finally, I wish to thank all those who have come to celebrate with us, patriarchs, major archbishops, cardinals, bishops, priests, religious, women and men from near and far, as well as those who followed us throughout the world on television. Holy Father, as we are coming to the end of a historic event, I assure you again of our love and our prayers. On behalf of the whole community gathered here, I ask you to give us your blessing.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Now and forever.
Our help is in the name of the Lord.
Who made heaven and earth.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Viva Papa!
Thank you.
Brothers and sisters, this is an important announcement. Please do not flock the gates. The first exit shall be for the green zone. Let us cooperate. We are a huge crowd. Let there be no stampede, no injuries. Please cooperate. The first exit shall be for the green zone. And then, as per the volunteers' instructions, we shall follow up and slowly exit the doors. Others, please be seated. Please cooperate. Green zone first. Merchandise corner will be open now, behind the white zone and also between the red and the blue zone. Please help yourselves. Please cooperate. Let us maintain the discipline. Thank you and God bless you.